Clarity on Fire, a podcast for people who know what they don't want out of their life and career, but aren't sure what they'd rather be doing.
In a world where it's easy to exist, but hard to feel alive, we, Kristen
and Rachel,
two certified life and career coaches, are here to help you cut through the information overload, get unstuck, and focus not just on how you can have a career you're passionate about, but how to create a whole life that feels fulfilling.
So join us here, where we serve up inspiration and down-to-earth wisdom in a way that only two best friends can.
We want you to experience the relief of knowing that, yes, you're allowed to want more out of your life and career.
And no, you don't have to wander through the dark anymore. Our job is to light the fire that shows you the way. Let's go.
You've been hearing us talk about this for a couple of weeks now. And today's the last day you'll hear about it for a little while, I promise. Because today is the last day of our current coaching enrollment period, which just means if you're pretty certain you want to do some form of coaching within the next few weeks.
You're seriously considering it.
Then today is the last day where you can officially sign up. After today, if you are listening after Tuesday the 31st, it's cool. You can still join the wait list and we'll just let you know when we have an availability pop up.
Do you remember the song After Today from the Goofy movie? It's a jam.
Barely.
It's a jam. I could sing the whole thing right now.
Didn't you and your brother love the Goofy movie
we
growing up?
We loved the Goofy movie. Loved,
it's a very good gender-neutral movie for two.
Oh my gosh.
Like a
and Powerline, he had some jams. Do you remember that?
Barely.
Oh my God. All right. I might have to institute a Goofy movie soundtrack.
Dance off
party at some point during this quarantine.
We gotta entertain ourselves somehow.
Yeah. So I know it's a weird time. Like, this was not an ideal time to do anything. And I don't know, but we're going to be here as long as people want to be coached.
Well, here's the thing. We've already had people saying, I totally intended to do coaching and now I have to reevaluate some things. And I've also had people come back and say, whoa, I was not thinking about doing coaching, but I need some coaching now.
Yeah.
So I get it. Plans are changing all around. And if you want some help with those plans, we're here. And if this is not a good time, okay, we'll be back.
Yeah, I will always be here. If the world goes back to normal in a month or two, you're like, I think now would be a good time. Just go to our site, go to one-on-one coaching page and just join the wait list and we'll reach out and just let you know where we're at. I have a feeling that, you know, this is going to be a weird spring. So normal rules don't apply. So don't act like normal rules apply. If you want to reach out to us about coaching, don't be afraid to. Just do it and we'll let you know where we're at. But yeah, today is the last day to officially sign up for this wave and sign up to talk to us. Of course, not sign up. We'll remind you about that at the end. Link in the episode notes. Of course, there is always everything interesting to discover.
Always.
So here we go. Here's a Magic 8-Ball episode.
Okay, so you shook up the Magic 8-Ball. What came out this time?
This is one of the very first blogs I published on the podcast 2 years ago. Original title is Why Watching Netflix is My Secret Life Purpose. I maintain nothing has changed since then.
Not so secret anymore, but
no,
still
I don't know if it was ever a secret. I'm pretty well known as an introverted homebody who loves Netflix. But it's not actually about Netflix. It's about creativity and what the definition of creativity is and isn't. And the reason I decided that this one was the one that we needed to revisit today or right now is because all of a sudden people have a lot more time to be creative. Like, not everyone, of course. Thank you to all of the doctors and nurses and people out there who are keeping things moving. You guys probably have no time.
Or the parents of kids who used to be in school who are now home.
Well,
you have less time, probably.
But a lot of time to be creative.
With your kids
with
sometimes.
Right. Yeah. Maybe more of a need to be creative and less structured, you know?
True.
So the problem is that a lot of us have hangups around what creativity means and we won't give ourselves permission to do stuff that's creative because it doesn't feel quote unquote productive. Or we have a messed up definition of like, oh, creativity is only artistic. And so if we find ourselves with more time on our hands and more time to potentially make things or create things, then I think we need to have a good relationship with the notion of creativity. So that's what this is about, is getting our minds right around that concept.
No, it's very timely. So, all right, let's get into it.
Why watching Netflix is my secret life purpose. Sometimes I feel like I've lived most of my life with only one foot in this realm. The other foot has been exploring Hogwarts or on a stroll with Lizzie at Longbourn or running away from White Walkers and toward Jon Snow, if you know what I mean. I've spent nearly 3 decades being mildly annoyed that real life gets in the way of fantasy. To me, fiction and art and music often feel more real and true than the monotony of everyday life, with its bills and laundry and mountains of responsibilities. Could you make a case that maybe this is a problem? That I'm trying to escape reality and live in a perpetual state of denial? You probably could. But hey, I'm still paying my bills and my laundry gets done and I'm not shirking my responsibilities, so cut me some slack. Thankfully, I found a way to weave creativity into my daily life. I'm not just absorbing other people's creativity in the form of books, movies, TV, music, and art. I've also built a business that's fueled by my own creative inspiration in the form of blogs and podcasts, mostly. But I get that a lot of people don't have that kind of seamless integration. I was talking to one of my clients, Gwen, about this recently. She was feeling guilty about wanting to pursue writing, something she finds really fun and inspiring because it's not practical. It got me thinking about how warped our definition of creativity is and how many weird rules we silently follow about what we're allowed to pursue creatively. I'm talking about why you should never feel guilty about doing what you love, be it writing, Netflix, or anything else, and what the real definition of creativity is. Gwen is one of those people I'm jealous of. When I asked Gwen what she loved about writing, she positively gushed. She said, "I don't feel like I'm the one controlling the story or the characters. It's more like I'm just getting to know them and recording what they say and do. It's like stumbling upon a parallel universe, and I get to discover a place that no one has seen yet and report back. I love getting to build new worlds. It's like I'm an archaeologist digging and brushing away at the dirt, following whatever path the story takes. I wish I had that experience with writing. It sounds amazing." But here's the thing. Gwen isn't a full-time writer. She has a very standard 9-to-5 job in the accounting field right now. She's not even sure she wants to be a professional writer. Maybe that'd put too much pressure on it and make it less fun. And yet throughout the day, she often gets intuitive nudges from the writing muse. She'll feel pulled to start working on a new story or get a jolt of inspiration that she's itching to pursue, but often won't allow herself to act on it when she has a slow moment in the office or after work, when she has time to write. When I asked why, she said, "This isn't my career, it's just a hobby. So I feel like real world stuff should come first. I feel like I shouldn't spend too much time on it, given what it is." This simultaneously broke my heart and pissed me off. I very quickly set the record straight with Gwen, and I highly suspect I need to do it for some of you too. So here's the deal. I fully understand why Gwen said what she did, but it's a warped conception of what creativity is all about. That statement, "it's just a hobby, so I've got to treat it accordingly," presumes that the best way to measure the worth of something is with metrics like titles, money, and prestige. As in, if someone is paying you to do something, that makes it more legitimate. Or if you can put it on your LinkedIn profile, that makes it real. Or if you've won a bunch of awards, somehow you've been validated. We assume that unless we have those type of stats, our pursuits aren't as important and are somehow less deserving of our time and attention. And sure, external validation can be nice, but it doesn't inherently change how creative something is. A book is a book, whether or not anyone ever reads it. And plenty of fantastic books have never seen the light of day. Does that somehow make the person who wrote them less creative? Can we agree on a new definition of creativity? If you want to read the textbook on this, you must stop what you're doing and read Big Magic by Elizabeth Gilbert. This book will change your life. In it, she defines creativity as the relationship between a human being and the mysteries of inspiration. That's it, broad and vague on purpose. She also says, "I believe this is one of the oldest and most generous tricks the universe plays on us human beings, both for its own amusement and for ours. The universe buries strange jewels deep within all of us and then stands back to see if we can find them. The hunt to uncover those jewels, that's creative living. The courage to go on that hunt in the first place, that's what separates a mundane existence from a more enchanted one. In other words, creativity is an internal journey. It's not about proving anything to anyone else. It's about discovering and expressing who we are. Full stop. By the way, creative doesn't necessarily mean artistic. The purest meaning of creativity is quite simply the use of imagination or original ideas. Imagination and originality can be applied to anything, not just art. Oh, and creativity also has nothing to do with how good you are at something. You don't have to have any talent to use your imagination and originality to express yourself. Good is relative anyway. No two people could agree on a precise definition of what that means. So if being talented or artistic isn't the point, and if making money and getting validated isn't the point, then what is the point of creativity? Here's what I told Gwen. The point of any creative pursuit is that it brings you joy. The reason it brings you joy is because in the moments you're absorbed in it, you're aligned with one of the most deep, true parts of who you are as a person. In other words, joy is just a side effect of being in alignment. And whatever form of creative expression speaks to you is like a fast track to finding that alignment. I've said it before, and I will say it until you are tired of hearing it. We are not here to be practical and then die. What exactly is the point of living in that scenario? We're here to express who we are and experience as much joy as we can along the way. Anything that lets you tap into that feeling is not superfluous. It's actually a huge point of what you're doing here in the first place. Which means that yes, all the books I've read and Netflix I've watched haven't been for nothing. When I'm doing it for the right reasons, as in I'm not numbing out and trying to avoid my life, it feeds my soul and brings me a lot of joy. My wish for Gwen, you, and me is that we care more about feeling good than we do about being practical, and that we start measuring our lives on a spectrum of joy rather than with dollars, metrics, and stats. And I guarantee you this, anyone who doesn't understand why you'd spend time pursuing things that bring you joy, even though you may not be good at them and you might not even earn you any money, is someone who hasn't yet, as Liz Gilbert would say, had the courage to hunt for their own strange jewels. So, how have you defined creativity? And have you allowed yourself to pursue the things that make you feel good, even if they're just hobbies? Come share with me in the comments. And I will link to the comments in the description of this episode. So click on that and tell me what you think. A question that occurs to me that other people might be thinking right now about the notion of one-on-one coaching is it the right time to do coaching if you don't know what your future looks like? Like, if you can't plan for the future, then is that a good time? I meet a lot of people who think that they have to have their ducks in a row before they go through with something like coaching. I think people know that they don't have to have their shit together when they show up at therapy, because like that's kind of the point, is you don't have to have it together. We're going to find it together there. But I don't think people realize that that's very much also what happens in coaching, is that you don't have to know like exactly how things are going to line up or how things are going to work out in order to get the most out of that experience. That it's part of the process is figuring it out.
Yeah, what coaching is helping you go from where you are now to where you want to be. And part of the process that we take our clients through is figuring out first, where do you want to be? Yeah. And then how do we get you there? So if the future is uncertain right now, that's to me, one of the better times to get some support in clarifying that rather than trying to do it on your own and then go to a coach.
Also, by the way, the future is always uncertain. We just think it's more certain than it is, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Now, obviously, things are even weirder. And I'm not here to preach about how, like, just be zen because, like, life is always uncertain.
No.
I cried yesterday about the uncertainty. So I'm right there with you. And I also have to be the person who walks my talk. And what I know that we do in coaching that is very valuable, no matter what's going on outside in the world, is that the first point is about becoming the kind of person you need to be in order to respond well to what happens in life, in order to discern with, like, clarity, not to be too on the nose, but that's kind of the point, is to be able to be really clear about how to make good decisions, building a filter system for yourself so that you can discern what's for me, what's not for me. I'm going to make confident, grounded decisions, and I'm not going to second guess myself. But in order to become that person, it requires a lot of inner work. So a lot of coaching, especially at the beginning, is not about you doing anything outside in the world. It's not about you responding to what's going on outside.
No, it's about building inner clarity. It's about building inner resilience. It's about becoming someone who trusts in your own decision-making and you know why you're choosing what you're choosing and you feel steady and intentional about that. That's all of what we're doing, which if you ask me, if there's a time for more resilience and more confidence in your own ability to make hard choices, it's now.
Yeah, for sure. So no, the answer to that question then is you do not need to know where you're going or what you're doing. That's kind of the point of figuring it out, even when life is presenting us with more question marks than we're used to. That's normal. That's okay, actually.
So with that said, I'm going to repeat what I already said at the beginning of this episode, which is that today is the last day for our coaching enrollment. If you are like, my life just turned up on its head and I really need some help in figuring out what to do.
Yeah.
That's...
And I maybe didn't know what to do before, but damn if I know now.
No, I really don't know.
Yeah.
Then this might be actually a good time for coaching, even though for some of you I know, I can't tell you what's right for you right now, but if it feels like in your gut, I need some help because this is also overwhelming. Mm-hmm. That's why we're here.
I need help. I've got more time on my hands than I'm used to. Help me make something good out of it.
Yes.
Also, just a quick reminder, too, that we said this once before, but I want to clarify it because we've had questions about this in the past. This is for new people and or former clients. So if you're someone who worked with us a while back and it's like, I think this would be a good time to revisit some stuff or, you know, kind of peel back another layer. This is for you, too.
I've had some of my old clients come back and say, okay, I was on a path and I had a plan and that plan is a little bit thrown off the tracks. So let's revisit. And that's fine.
Okay. So again, link in the episode notes if you want to talk to us about it. We'll be scheduling those within like the next couple weeks, usually, if we hear from you. And then we will be back on Friday with a new Dear Crachel, the theme of which is, unshockingly, anxiety, depression, panic, and PTSD. Oh my.
Which means we can all relate. All right, we'll see you then.
Bye.